YouTube, Dawson Ryder here with a review of the Arrow Oliver Queen and Deathstroke figure set, otherwise known as Arrow and Deathstroke figure set. So just slightly warned, there will be minor spoilers in this review, mainly pertaining to suit-like things, so just so you know. So anyway, I have been doing a few off-genre reviews for my channel for a little bit, just for, you know, random fun. And this one I really wanted to do because Arrow is really, like, one of my favorite shows that I watch right now, and I really wanted to get this figure set, and I quite enjoy these figures, so I thought I'd bring a review. But anyway, if you couldn't tell by the fact that I said it twice already, this set contains the Arrow, Oliver Queen from the first season, and Deathstroke. This is the wintergreen version of Deathstroke from the island from season one. I suppose you could pretend that it is, you know, Slade from the island in season two and, you know, partly one, because he had a mask that he wore like that sometimes then during season two that he put on, so that was the minor spoiler. But anyway, still very cool. So let's go ahead and get started. We'll start with Deathstroke here, just because. So yeah, like I said, it is the wintergreen version from the island storyline. With the exception of the outfit not being completely like it, you could pretend it is Slade, because he did don the mask like this later. But still, it's pretty cool to have this figure. And it is overall pretty well done. Both figures are overall pretty well done. They're nice, solid figures. The details on them are very well done. The mask here honestly looks pretty decent. You can sort of see his eyes there, the sort of cloth-like effect on the mask. These details, like, on his gear here are well done. You can see these little things around here. Around here you got his blade in a sheath. You can actually pull the blade out. Here it is. It's pretty well done. It's really nice looking. It's actually got quite a bit of various accessories that he came with that are all on various places on his person. Like right here is his handgun right here. Pretty well done. I had it in his hand. He also got an automatic weapon, which I just fell, which is right here, which I had him holding, but for whatever reason I had to take out of his hand because it was giving him a hard time standing. I don't know why. There is a little holster right here for his gun right there. And you can see they did a really good job of sort of getting the cloth details of the pants, sort of armored boots here. Down here is another sheath here for a knife, which is also removable, so you can have him hold that. So you can see that there's various places to store all this stuff. You do have a couple little storage places back here, but these aren't actually for the weapons. They're just for show. Almost knocked over Oliver there. But overall, a really nice-looking figure. And articulation-wise, these are also very well done. They're on a nice little hinge joint here. They're actually really, really tight joints up here and on the arm, so it's hard to move, but you can get a great 360 range of motion and in-and-out motion here. You do have a single elbow joint here, which is also very tight around to move. You can swivel here. You can swivel at the fists as well. You do have a little bit of waist articulation here, so you can get some solid movement. The legs are also on a hinge joint, so you can get a pretty decent range of movement, not as well as the arms, but you can get some back and forth and side to side. On both of them, I notice on mine, the legs are smidged loose, which is really one of my only complaints about the mold. They're not, like, terrible, but definitely a lot looser than the arm joint up here. You can swivel here at the leg. You've got a nice, hinged knee joint here, so you got, like, double knee joint action, so you can get some great solid movement there. And this joint actually is a great deal tighter than the joint up here, and you have it both places here and here, so you get some great range of motion there. There's a nice little ball joint here on the foot, so you can move the foot in some pretty decent directions forward and back. Not really side to side all that much, but overall, very solidly articulated. My main problems with this figure overall are, like I mentioned, well, the handgun just fell out. I'm just gonna put it in the holster. Are the loose leg joint problems. It's, like I said, it's not terribly loose, but it's just loose enough to be annoying. And for whatever reason, I have an absolutely awful time trying to get this guy to stand. It, like, took me, like, upwards of 7 minutes trying to get this guy to stand just for the review. So I'm not sure why. I guess the leg is a little bit off. I can see his foot's a little uneven and it's hard to fix. And that combined with the slightly loose legs just makes him really difficult to deal with. So don't be surprised if he just spontaneously falls over when we're talking about Arrow here. So Arrow Arrow, my personal favorite of the two figures, mainly because, you know, he's the Arrow, is really nicely done. If you can just sort of see by looking at it, he's really, really awesome. So this is the Season 1 version, meaning there's not like a huge amount of differences, the main one just being that his face has the grease paint mask as opposed to the other mask, which he gets in Season 2. That's what I meant by minor spoilers. But detail-wise, this guy is really well done here. Let's take a look at the face. You know, he looks a little bit dead-eyed and his eyes look a little funny, but overall, I think they did a really good job of capturing Ollie's face. It looks pretty much just like him. You got the beard there. They did a really good job capturing his look. The hood here is sort of based on rubber, and you can actually, if you work with it a little bit, there you go. I told you Deathstroke was going to fall over. You can actually pull it off, and you can reveal his hair. Show accurate hair. So it looks the same. It looks really funny if you have the hood off, because it's not like a cloth material that naturally rests. But being noted, or just note that you can take that off. But everything else looks really accurate. Here's the hood, you know, Shadow's old hood. It looks really good. They do a really good job here representing the sort of cloth-like material and the way it would move and whatnot. So overall, very well done. Like I said, the head sculpt is really nicely done on there and did a good job on it, and then, you know, the rest of his suit is also very well done. It's just aesthetically very very nice looking figures. He's also decked out with a bunch of different accessories, most of which are on him right now, and most of which, well, actually, pretty much all. The only accessory that's not is you do have interchangeable hands for him. I suppose you can switch them out for Slate as well, but they are just closed fists, because right now he has you know, things to operate his bow and arrow. So this piece here really isn't that removable. These pieces molded on, and I suppose you could remove the belt if you really wanted, but you have some smaller arrows here on the side. On the back here, you do get his holder here for his arrows, his quiver, and you get several different sort of things. You get here just like a stack of regular arrows all together to place back here, and then you have two individual arrows, which look pretty nice. They even have, let me get one, it's easier, the green arrow tip. Hold on. There he stood. The arrow tip right there. So you have two there, so that you can pose it with the bow, which is really nice. And then right here, we will take it out of his hand momentarily. We have his bow right here, which is really nicely detailed. It's the one mainly from the first season, but really nice details on it, and you have this little cloth string here, so you can actually pose him in shooting an arrow position, which I will show, which actually works pretty well. The articulation on this guy is the exact same as Slade's, the same joints here. His legs are a little loose still, but not Slate, I'm sorry, it's not Slate technically, but the articulation is the same. The loose leg joint problem is here still on his. I do not have as much trouble standing him at all. The only difference really between his articulation and Deathstroke's is that his head is a little harder to move because of the hood, so you can't really get him in as many dynamic poses, but you can essentially get him in dynamic poses within the hood to give him a mysterious look, so that's really not that much of a fault. But anyway, the articulation on, as you saw with Deathstroke, is pretty solid on these. It is just enough so that it does look a smidge strange when he's, you know, holding back for an arrow. Like, damn it, like he just drops it all of a sudden. It's like, that's awkward, right? But it's still, it's nice that the articulation is still there enough so that you can do it. So the way I usually do it is I pull the string back here. It's actually easier if I turn it this way for now. So there's like a little notch right here between, I'm going to zoom in a smidge. There's a little notch in here between his fingers where you can place the arrow to hold, like that. But if you place the string in between his fingers first, which can take a little bit of work, especially when you're on camera for whatever reason, you can place the arrow in front of it and get it to hold. And you can like mess with this to get it to look better. I'm just doing it real quick to show you. Alright, so I cut away for a sec just to maneuver it a little bit better. It's still not perfect. For whatever reason, it was giving me trouble now that I was doing it. But as you can see, you can get him to hold it. I usually have the arrow on the other side. But you can get him to hold the arrow and the bowstring, and then sort of having it in a shooting position, which can look pretty sweet. As you can see from angles like this, or maybe like this, it might look a little funny. But if you can get it in the right angle, it's pretty awesome that you're able to do it, because, you know, there's quite a bit of various figures that are based on Archer heroes or whatnot that can't even do this. So it's nice nice that you're able to, even if it does look awkward from some angles. It's really actually pretty neat that you can do that. I'll probably mess with it more later to get a better pose for, you know, display. And, you know, it's not quite the best, but still, it looks nice. But overall, I really, really like this figure set. My main problems are only really that the legs were a little bit loose. That tends to happen with a lot of figures, which is kind of annoying. And like I said, repeating myself for the third time, it's not, like, amazingly loose. Like, if I go like this, you know, that did move a little bit, but it's not like they're going... And I have a lot of older figures that do that, so it's not, like, amazingly bad. So that was really my only main complaint across the board for the two of them, is the loose joints on the legs. And then for Deathstroke here, being able to stand is an issue, which may or may not just be mine personally. But those are my only main issues. The only other slight nitpick or suggestion I would have for the figures is that I wish the articulation was a little bit more on the arms, just so that Ollie's, you know, shooting an arrow pose would look a little bit smoother. Like I said, it's still really neat that you're able to do it at all, which is cool. But if it was just a little bit more bending at the elbows or something, it could look a little more natural from all angles. But other than that, it's not a huge deal. I'm glad for Deathstroke giving me something to do during these last couple minutes by trying to straighten them out. But overall, I'm still really pleased with the set. I think they're really fantastic figures. They look absolutely amazing on the shelf. You can get them in some pretty awesome poses. And I'm just really impressed, especially with how accurate they got Oliver's face on there. So it looks really nice. I definitely hope for more sets from these. It actually would have been neat if they would have given a Island Deathstroke and sort of Island Oliver set, and then done, you know, maybe a set with this version of Arrow with, like, Malcolm Merlyn, and then a new set with Season 2 Arrow, which would essentially just be the same figure, pretty much, with the exception of the mask, and then, you know, Slade Deathstroke. So, but you never know, we'll probably get more figures later, but that's how I would have done it. But still, very cool set. If you're a fan of Arrow, I definitely recommend at least checking this out. Very neat figure set. But that about wraps it up. Until next time, make sure you check out the Crazy Podcast at WritersRangersRambles.com, and don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. Until next time, it's Dawson Writer, signing out.